First pitch coming. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting toward the third base dugout. Leaning, and he makes the catch. Oh, he took it right out of the dugout for the second out. Wow. Reese will stand in here, hoping to pick up his club's first hit in the contest. Reese swinging a high pop-up straight back, though it looks as though he'll have room back there. And he will make the catch here just in front of the first row, and that will end the inning. Pee-wee Reese will stand in now, hoping to get on top of one for a change. He's popped out in successive plate appearances. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Come set, now the pitch. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. From the stretch. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. One run, two hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. Now the 1-2. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Big pitch here, 1-2. And a swing and a ball hit foul heading for the seats. So another foul ball here, and it remains 1-2. Now another 1-2. And look out as that one ran in and got him.
You can see the pitching coach heading for the mound. And this is nothing more than just trying to reassure your guy and give him a chance to compose himself. He's been great so far, so there's no reason to think that he can't work out of this.
Brandon Phillips will step in. He homered his last time around. Here comes the 1-2.
We got one here.
Now a ball rolls softly to second. Throw to first takes care of Phillips, and he's retired for out number two.
Well, only three strikeouts for him in the ball game, but when you've got that slow stuff keeping guys off balance, you don't need to rely on strikeouts.
Payoff pitch coming. And a fastball swung on and hit to second. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. One left for Cincinnati. They still trail it here 3-1. Sam LaCure will come on now as he'll start out the bottom of the sixth. Pee-wee Reese will be the first one to greet him, as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here.
Pee-wee Reese.
Ooh, he saws him off with that one. One away.
Well, let's just see if we can slow this way down and see the point of impact. He's going to be bunched up a little bit on this one and get it right down below the label. And sure enough, that's a great shot right there. This bat just explodes on impact.
On to first, and that's an important first out to start the eighth here.
Yeah, another good start to an inning for him here. He's really only made one bad pitch the entire game. That was the solo home run. Other than that, you can see there, not much to speak of at all.
2-2. And a jam shot here as this is sent towards second. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. And guys, we were treated to an excellent pitching performance in this one by the gentleman you see.
Thank you.
And let's not forget our two starting pitchers as you see how they match up for this one.
Pee-wee Reese
will get his first cuts now, and he'll do so with the bases empty and two away here in the first. Line down the left field line. But this is going to get foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. Now the pitch. Now the 0-1 is swung on and lifted out to straightaway center field. Hamilton will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Jordan Pacheco will start things off here for Cincinnati with Joey Votto to follow next. Fastball swung on and grounded out towards second. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Yeah, there's a good start to the inning. He gets a nice little Sunday hop, and it's a day early at that. And he's able to make the easy play over to first.
Now here's the first pitch. Driven down the left field line. Will it stay fair? It will, just to the right of the chalk, a fair ball. This is going to kick off the fence now out in front of the Arizona bullpen. And he's in there safely. He's got a double. Justin Ruggiano will stand in. He grounded out his first time. And the runner's breaking for third. Pitch outside. The throw. Not in time, as he just does get in there ahead of the throw.
Normally, when you see a guy steal third base, it's because he got a nice walking lead. Really got out there nice and far. But here, he had almost no lead whatsoever when he made his break. Very fortunate to get away with that one.
Full count pitch on its way. Here's a swing and a high pop-up drifting toward the third base dugout, and that's going to land foul.
Come on, let it rip right here.
The next 3-2. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. The next 3-2. Oh, this is hit hard toward second. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. Billy Hamilton will stand in again. A couple of groundouts for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second, and that's through, a base hit. Take that big turn at first. And that is where the wheels pay off, as he's able to make it into second with a hustle double. Justin Ruggiano will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ballgame. Runners on his way to third. Pitches a called strike. The throw not in time, as he just does get in there ahead of the throw.
And let's just train our camera on that runner leading off from second. He's watching that pitcher like a hawk. So once he sees that he's not paying attention to him, he just takes off. And the head first slide gets him into third just ahead of the throw.
A couple of lefties start to get loose now in the bullpen. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Votto is there and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. One left for Arizona. Still a 3-2 ball game. Pee-wee Reese will have a shot at driving home that possible tying run that's standing at second. Here's the first offering. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle.
Right here, find the ball. Here we go, go, go.
And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him. And that's going to tie our ball game as the runner scores from second to make it 3-3 now. Justin Luciano will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
Kind of chance of redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. He can make up for it.
Meanwhile here, the throw to third is not in time, and he's in there safely. Ready with the 2-1. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
He knows the drill out there. You've got to make him swing the bat. Not be giving up walks at this stage of the game, because those could be fatal.
And now the Reds are going to get the bullpen moving here. It's a lefty and a right-hander up and throw. And he missed with it there, ball four. It's a two-out walk with the runner still at third. So a call to the bullpen now, and they'll make a move for the left-hander here. David Peralta will get his shot now with two on and two out here in inning number seven. 1-1. Down low again, it's 2-1.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in the strike zone.
Oh, he wanted that one, but it misses for ball three.
Well, got the matchup he wanted, but that's not going to amount to much if he can't throw strikes.
Nate Scherholz will dig in now, 1-for-2 to this point. He waits. Now the pitch. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? Pennington on to first, and they turn the double play. Pee-wee Reese will be the first to meet him here, and he'll do so in an enviable situation indeed. Bases loaded and only one out now. Hammered the other way to deep right field. And that one is out of here. Planted into the right field bleacher. So one swing, and he unloads the bases on that one. Home run number 16 for him on the year, as it's now a six-run ball game.
Yeah, you feel a little for that guy on the mound. He was in an impossible spot to begin with. He didn't start this mess, but definitely makes it worse by giving up the grand slam.
And fellas, as always, a few guys we could have chosen from, but out of everybody, that's the man who stands out in my book. He's our top player of the game.
Well, he winds up with 3/4 of the cycle. Couldn't quite squeeze in the triple, but that's all right. Definitely did enough to earn himself the hardware.